This is the last part of a mini guide to KeePass, an open source, free, and offline password manager. Today we are going to create our password database, strengthen it, and learn its basic features. Let's begin. Open keepass.exe and click on Enable Automatic Update Check. As said on the dialog box, updates are not downloaded or installed automatically. This is a good security practice, since it forces you to check that the new release is not malicious. You will have to download it from the official website and proceed again with the validation steps outlined in my previous video. Click on the new icon and read what the box says, in particular this. You should regularly create a backup of the database file onto an independent data storage device. Because this database is not stored online, but locally on the SSD or HDD of your computer, if they irreparably break, you lose all your passwords. You may think, I'll upload it on my cloud service then. No, your database must always be offline. So, after creating the original version, go and make several backup copies on different USB drives and external HDDs. Now click OK, choose a name and your preferred location, and save. As the master password, namely the only password you'll have to memorize, I obviously suggest something easy to remember and at least 20 characters long, for instance. But in its current form, this is not hard enough. We could change the first and last letters of each word to uppercase. "122" is better than 106, but we still haven't maxed out the quality bar. Therefore, I suggest a simple substitution cipher. Instead of pressing the correct key, press the one above it, if present. For example, and keep in mind I'm using an Italian layout on my keyboard, uppercase L becomes uppercase O, I becomes 8, K becomes I, uppercase E becomes uppercase 3, so the pound symbol, and so on. The end result will be this. The cool thing is that, technically, you don't know your own master password, just the characters from which it derives and its derivation pattern. Now we want to enable a second layer of security, aka two-factor authentication. Click on Show Expert Options, Key File Provider, Browse, All Files. Here, I suggest choosing a key file that cannot be easily altered, like a PDF, an MP3, and a like. For the purpose of my video, I'll select this song. While the master password is something you must know, the key file is something you must possess in order to open your database. The two of them together constitute the 2FA. The first factor is knowledge, the second factor is possession. In the absence of either, you will never be able to access your database again, so backups are essential. Making a safe backup of your master password might be a topic of a future video, if you're interested enough. For the moment, just don't forget it. As for your key file, keep several backup copies on various storage devices, themselves different from those used for your database. Finally, click OK, OK again, and skip. We'll deal with those options later. First, I will show you the importance of not altering the content of your key file in any way. If I compute the SHA-256 of my original MP3, it's this one. and the database opens. Now I will rename my MP3 and compute its hash again. It's the same as before, so the database will still open. Now I will edit the details of my MP3 and compute its hash for the third time. It's awfully different. Hence, the database will not open. Now I will revert the edits and compute its hash for the last time. It's the same as the original. Thus, the database will now reopen. What should you learn from these four tests? Renaming your file doesn't alter its content. In fact, the hash remains the same. On the other hand, editing the details of your file does alter its content. In fact, the hash changes. Now you know what you can and cannot do with your key file. Next, we must strengthen the database. Click on File, Database Settings, Security, Encryption Algorithm, use the default Advanced Encryption Standard, Key Derivation Function, choose Argon2D. Since it offers a better protection against password cracking using GPUs and ASICs. Iterations start with 2. Memory, if your device has 1 GB of RAM or less, set half of it. For instance, 512 MB with 1 GB of RAM. If your device has more than 1 GB of RAM, set 1 GB. Parallelism, set the number of your logical processors, which you can easily find by opening your task manager. Performance, CPU, logical processors will appear here instead of virtual ones. Click on Test. If it reports a value between 1 and 2 seconds, that's a reasonable delay. If it's above 2 seconds, decrease memory. If it's below 1 second, increase iterations, like I have to do. Then we must strengthen KeePass itself. Click on Tools, Options, Security. Here you can set many options as you prefer, but the single most important one is this. Enter Master Key on Secure Desktop. In such a way, the initial master key dialog box will appear on a different and secure desktop, almost like the user account control box you see every day. I mean this one. Notice the darker background? Before, there was no protected desktop, namely one that provides better resistance against keyloggers. At last, we can safely use our database. Now delete those 2 sample entries. Select them, right-click, delete. Yes, but you still find them inside the recycle bin. Right-click, empty it, delete. To create new groups, click on group, add a group, name it, and select an icon. To create a new entry, click on this button. Title, let's say YouTube. Username, YouTube. @gmail.com. Password, click on the generate a password icon. Open password generator. Length, at least 20 characters, as I said before. Select these entries, uppercase, lowercase, digits, minus, underline, special, brackets, and a tick, show dialog for collecting user input as additional entropy. Now move your mouse inside the left box, bash your keys inside the right one, and press OK. Your new password will look something like this one. Quite safe, I would say. Finally, URL. Copy-paste the official login page and always double-check it's indeed the one and only. Now, when you want to log in into that website, you just have to right-click on its entry, URL, open or select an option, right-click, copy username, paste. You have 12 seconds to do it before the clipboard is cleared. Right-click, copy password, paste. Again, you have 12 seconds, and then proceed as usual. As in, you must open your authenticator app and enter the appropriate 2FA code. Congratulations! At this point in time, you should have a basic understanding of some of the best security practices to keep your passwords safe with KeePass. Farewell for now.